There must be a reason why so many gay football players will not say how they want to live.
It's about making sure that everyone is treated equally and it's okay to be who you are and be true to yourself.
It's a great campaign and it looks good.
It does look good. Rainbow colours look amazing.
So, the question is, why are we here?
Yeah, we're here because of a very important cause, I think, to the club and to a lot of the members at the club for the Rainbow Laces campaign.
Exactly. Yeah. So the question was a bit more philosophical. Why do we have to be here and still talk about it? Because you are, to say it in English, it's an openly...
Yeah, openly gay footballer, yeah.
Openly gay footballer.
Yeah. I think in women's football, I've been very fortunate that it's not as unusual and it's very accepted and, yeah, the community is very strong. But I think for the entirety of football, there's still a lot of work that needs to be done, especially on the men's side, just to make it a platform that it's accepted and that, yeah, it's okay to be who you are and be true to yourself.
That's what life is about. Eh?
Yeah.
So the thing is, and I'm 100% sure it's not a problem in a dressing room, So which is obviously the starting point for it. I don't know how much it would be a problem in a football stadium. There must be a reason why so many gay football players will not say what they think, how they want to live.
In the change rooms, I don't think it's a problem, but I think potentially outside, there's a lot of external factors and opinions that are maybe a little bit outdated, and it's just about making sure that everyone is treated equally and not, yeah, looked down upon for their sexuality or how they present. And yeah, if someone does, you know, step out and say, this is who I am, then that's accepting them for them and, yeah, making it a place that's safe.
I think one of the issues is that if you do it, The whole world makes a big fuss of it, and it's a part of life where you don't want to make a big fuss. It's private,
But
you have to go and open up, and that's it so strange as well.
Yeah, no.
It's like you sit there and cameras from all over the world, and Here's one, and how do you feel about it?
No, I agree. I think for me, I was very fortunate to be surrounded by a very supportive network and my family and friends, and they accepted me for who I am. But I think on the men's side, there is a lot of stigma around being who you are and the outing. We need to create that platform where if someone does come out and says, you know, identifies who they are, that there isn't like a big fuss made about it, because it should just be, you know?
Exactly. Yeah, exactly. Is it like you have, as a gay person, you have pretty much two outings in your life? You have one when you have to, you realize it, But then you have to tell it your parents. Is it like that?
Yeah,
is that
I think so. I think for me, on a more personal note, I was very young, and I think my mum already knew. Like most mums, they know everything. So, yeah, it was more for me, I think, to my friends and then my wider family. And then, yeah, in a football setting, maybe even a third time when if you want to publicly announce it or, like, say it to the world almost. And I think for me that came more naturally. I just sort of, made a post around the timing of the year when we do sort of celebrate and highlight these issues. I feel, not that it's a job for me to, you know, put myself out there, but I always think, and the way I carry myself, I can affect another young person or someone around my age, and they can see me out there being...
You are still young.
Being honest. Yeah, I know.
25.
Yeah. You know what I mean? But being honestly who I am and being true to me, and that helps them, you know, come to terms with what they're dealing with, then that's amazing.
Is there a number or an email address which, if I want to talk about it, for footballers or in general, where you just call?
I think the Rainbow Laces do have a contact that you can obviously reach out to and talk to. And
but that's probably the moment where we have to put the number under. Underline the picture with the number. That's it.
Yeah, we
I'm
can
I'm used
point.
To that feeling, exactly. Look here.
Look here. Yeah, well, I guess Stonewall's main message this season is lace up, speak up. I think for me personally, obviously I will be wearing the, show and tell. I will be wearing the laces to show my support, and obviously being a out and proud footballer, so it's a visibility kind of thing. It's to encourage others to speak up, like we say, highlighted, to reach out if you need help or you need guidance or any sort of forms of information, I guess, to help you as an individual. What about you, Jürgen? How do you feel about it?
Great, they will stay in there. So I really love the whole, every year when it happens. I'm a perfect example for it, how much awareness, how the awareness level change in a moment when you put them in.
Yeah.
So you should try, really, it feels great. Yeah. And you can put awareness on something, which is obviously really important.
Yeah.
I think to really understand it, because that's the problem. And it's difficult, I'm 54, I've went through a lot of periods in my life, but a lot of problems I never had.
Yeah.
So it means you talk about it like an interested viewer. It's like, oh yeah, well, how would that be? How would that feel?
Yeah.
And I never had the problem, but I have so many gay friends
mm-hmm.
in our age now, but I never thought about how it was when they had to say, by the way, mom, dad, whoever else. I'm not exactly how you expected it, maybe.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a challenge we should not face in the way we face it in our life.
Yeah.
So that's it. And that's how it still is, obviously. And whatever I can do, I can say today, here, live, on camera, I will do.
Mm-hmm.
I'm completely in. It's a great campaign, I have to say.
No, I agree.
And it looks good.
It does look good. Rainbow nice colors look amazing. They bring a smile to everybody's face. As an ally, it's so important for us to have people like you who are, you know, in our corners and standing behind us and supporting us. And the biggest thing you can do is listen and support and educate yourself if you don't know. Because I think, that's maybe an area that a lot more people can maybe place more attention on, is just educating. Because at the end of the day, we're all people, we're all humans, you know, we're all doing the same thing, we're all kicking a ball around, you know. So, I totally agree with everything you're saying, and your support means everything.
Great, I'm in.
Perfect.
I said it
Me
on
too.
Television.